Okay, this will be the first episode back sa Las Piñas, back sa city. So if you're a new subscriber here, let me introduce myself first. My name is Jack. I do personal finance videos here on YouTube. Sometimes I do self-help. Sometimes I just do some personal videos. Pero most of the time, I do personal finance videos. And yun, if you're a returning subscriber, welcome back to the channel. So for today, gusto ko lang pag-usapan is yung article that I saw last year pa, pero I took a break. So ngayon ko lang siya gagawa ng video. So yung article is like Filipino Investing Myths that prevents us from starting to invest. So yun, let's talk about that article. Sabi dun sa article, most Filipinos do not see the need to have investments. It's not just in our psyche. According to investment expert Rafi Ayusted Jr., if you look at government data, 75% of the Filipino adult population or 54 million Filipinos have not invested in anything at all. The top reason cited is work instability, but for others, investing is simply seen as something costly to do or an unnecessary expense. Some also say they're content with their savings. I guess that statement clearly says that we do really have a problem in starting to investing, and this article na they stated 4 myths that stops us from starting to invest, and yun yung discuss natin in this video. Myth number 1, you need a big sum of money to start investing. I think ito yung pinakauna natin tinatanong sa sarili natin when the idea of investing pops into our head, diba? Magkano nga ba yung kailangan kong ilabas sa pera para makapagsimula ako mag-invest, diba? And I think magandang tanong to. Pero kung wala kang idea, I want you to take a guess sa comment section kasi gusto ko rin pakita yung perspective ng karamihan kung magkano nga ba yung idea nila kung magkano yung kailangan na capital to start investing. So I'll pause this video for a few seconds and it will start in 3, 2, 1. Okay, I hope nakapag-guess na kayo ng sagot nyo dun sa comment section. So ito, yung initial capital requirement of most investment houses ngayon is at 1,000 pesos na lang. So sobrang affordable na niya kung titingnan mo parang limang order na lang yan sa Shopee or kaya naman limang Starbucks coffee mo lang yan. So I hope if ikaw yung nag-guess na nasa hundreds of thousands to millions yung capital requirement to start investing, I hope ngayon na alam mo, na alam mo na hindi pala siya ganun kamahal. I hope if you have the idea starting to invest this year, sana naman ituloy mo na yan knowing na hindi naman siya ganun kamahal. I think there's a time pa nga na yung Sun Life Asset Management, yung mutual funds ng Sun Life is nag-offer sila ng promo na initial capital requirement to open an investment account sa yung mutual fund for as low as 500 pesos. So alam mo yun, sobrang mura, and I wanted to really encourage you na if you have the idea na mag-start kayo mag-invest this year, ngayon January pa lang, simulan nyo na mag-open na investment accounts nyo. So ayun, I hope makapag-invest kayo this year. Myth number 2, investing is complicated. I think for this one, this is just a matter of self-realization na kailangan mo matuto mag-invest. And kahit pa paano kasi kailangan mo din mag-invest ng effort to search and aralin yung mga basic terms na ginagamit sa investing or sa personal finance. Okay, yung mga sinayit nilang example dun sa article are coupon rate. So in layman's term, ang katumbas lang naman niya is interest rate. Ang government securities, these are just bond issued by the government. So basically, mangungutang sa inyo yung gobyerno, magpapautang kayo ng pera, at tutubo kayo dahil may katumbas na interest yon. Pag naman nakakarinig kayo ng T-bills, ang katumbas lang naman niya is short-term bond. So maikling papautangan niyo yung government at a short period of time. So usually, less than 1 year yan. Pag naman nakakarinig kayo ng stocks, ng equities, ng shares, so iba't iba man pakinggan, pero isa lang yung ibig sabihin yan. It's a form of ownership in a company. Learning how to invest is like learning addition when you are 4 or 5 years old, diba? At that time, parang sobrang complicated pa ng addition. Pero after several years of using it and trying yung addition, maiisip mo sobrang basic lang pala nito. And it's the same with any skill, and it's also the same with investing. Okay, after learning the basic terms, you need to learn yung basic strategy. So, sinayit nila dun sa article na EIP yung nire-recommend nilang basic investing strategy. So, ibig lang mong sabihin niya is easy investment program, or sa common investing term is cost averaging. So, ano ba yung ginagawa mo dito? So basically, what you will do is you're going to invest a specific amount of money at a specific set period of time. So for example, 2,000 every month, or kaya naman 5,000 every quarter, or kaya naman 20,000 annually. Ang importante, consistent ka. Kasi ang gusto mo lang naman gawin doon is makabay ka sa highs and makabay ka sa bottoms. Kasi in the long run, in 10 years plus perspective ng stock market, uptrend naman yung stock market. So pag ganun yung ginawa mong strategy, most likely mag-gain ka in the long run. Myth number 3, you need a lot of time to study and understand investing. It's almost similar sa myth number 2. Pero when it comes to the amount of time, I think just one day na sobrang focus ka mag-study is enough for you to grasp yung very basics para makapag-start ka. And ano lang ba yung requirements dyan? So basically, kailangan mo lang ng valid IDs, minsan 1, minsan 2, depende dun sa investment house. And then the number, and then yung minimum initial requirement, and then kailangan mo lang sagutin yung questionnaires nila. And I suggest before ka palang pumunta dun sa investing house, I suggest kaya mo na sagutin dapat yung mga questionnaires nila sa'yo, and ikaw mismo yung mag-assess sa sarili mo. So yung mga basic questions na i-ask sa'yo dun is, why are you investing? Para saan ba yung pinag-iinvestan mo ng capital mo or ng money mo? Pang tuition ba yan ng anak mo sa college? Pang wedding fund ba yan? Pang travel fund ba yan? Pang kotse ba yan? Pang bahay na yan? You have to know yung reason kung bakit ka nag-i-invest. And then, ano ba yung time horizon mo sa investing mo? Below 5 years ba kailangan mo na i-pull out yung money mo? Between 5 to 10 years ba yung time horizon mo sa pag-i-invest mo? Or more than 10 years? Tapos yung next question is, are you an aggressive investor, conservative investor ka ba, or are you a moderate investor? So, alam mo yun, within a day, sa sarili mo pala, tingin ko kaya mo na sagutin yung mga yan. So, yun, napaka-basic nun. So, those are the basic questions na I think kailangan mong sagutin sa sarili mo before ka pumunta sa investment house. And yun, kaya mo yun in a day. Pero still, investing is a lifelong skill and it takes lifelong learning. Pero I think may enjoy mo yan, especially pagka nakikita mo na yung results and yung progress mo. Myth number 4, investing is for older adults only. I think this is a common misconception na naisip natin or akala natin. I think business and money are for well-established people only. And sabi pa nga sa akin nung mom ko before na business are only for people na meron ng family business na naka-established. And I think those are just concepts and ideas and those are not facts. If you're a parent, I highly suggest na turuan mo yung kid mo mag-invest. And I think yung best example dyan para matuto sila is for you to set an example. Dapat ikaw din nag-i-invest. And then, help them open an investment account kahit bata pa sila. And dapat turuan nyo din sila mag-set aside ng extra money and teach them na ilagay nila yun sa investment account nila. And I think para sa akin yung pinaka-important na thing there is that makuha nila yung habit of setting aside extra money na i-invest nila para when they're an adult already, naka-intak na sa kanila yung habit na yun. If you are in your teens already, I highly suggest na mag-ipon muna kayo ng minimum initial capital, kahit 1,000 pesos lang yan. And then approach nyo yung parents nyo or guardians nyo na tulungan kayo mag-invest. If meron niyang investment accounts, I think madali kayong tutulungan yan. Pero if yung case mo is wala silang investment accounts, if you are the kid na may investment account and yung parents mo or guardians mo yung mag-ask ka ng tulong sa kanya and wala silang investment account, it would be really weird. So I suggest arali mo na yung mga pwede nila itanong sa'yo para pag nagtanong sila, masasagot mo yung tanong nila, kasi it's a really weird situation na ikaw yung bata and then yung mas matanda siya yung walang investment account and then mag-ask ka na mag-invest ka. So, yun. Pero I highly encourage you na subukan nyo pa rin even though ganun yung situation nyo, because you'll never know, diba? So, I just wish you the best of luck sa ganung situation. So, yun. Never limit your investment ideas or business ideas dahil lang sa edad nyo. That's it for the very first personal finance video of the year. I hope you have the idea na mag-start mag-invest this year. I hope ma-achieve mo yan and ituloy mo yan. Never let this myths or misconception stop you from investing this year. Again, there's no easy money in the real world. Everything needs dedication, patience, and a learning process. And I hope more Filipino would be financially literate and hindi na tayo ma-victim ng mga pyramid scam, yung mga easy money shit na yan. So, yun. Before we end this video na lang, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe if you aren't already, and let me know in the comment section yung investing plan nyo for the year, and let me be your accountability partner, your investing accountability partner for the year. So, ayun lang. See you in the next video. Peace out. Bye!